Will you pray with me, please? All-wise God, we thank you for giving us this time to look into our words, thoughts, and deeds. We confess that we fool ourselves into believing that we possess all the knowledge that we need. As we go from place to place, we try to block you out. Even though we say we want to hear your word and speak with you, we fail to see that we are always in your presence. We stray, seeking other gods, whose ways may be easy but cannot show us the ways of love and truth. We are afraid of being fed with the living bread of Jesus. Fill us with the Holy Spirit that we might live each day according to your will and plan for us and for your world. Help us to discern your wisdom that we might live eternally with you and Christ. Amen.
John chapter 6, verses 51 through 58. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats of this bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give for the life of the world is my flesh. The Jews then disputed among themselves, saying, "How can this man give us his flesh to eat?" So Jesus said to them, "Very truly, I tell you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you. Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood have eternal life, and I will raise them up on the last day, for my flesh is true food and my blood is true drink. Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood abide in me and I in them. Just as the living Father sent me and I live because of the Father, so whoever eats me will live because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven, not like that which your ancestors ate, and they died. But the one who eats this bread will live forever." God bless the reading of their word.
Praises, alleluia.
Have you ever gone by an accident on the road and everybody slows down? Where I come from in Ohio, we call that rubbernecking. And everyone, wants to see what has just happened. And kind of afraid to see it all at the same time. Or sometimes when there's things that go on, maybe on this, they've got a part of the sidewalk closed off and there's a crime scene, and you'll hear an officer say, "Go on, people, nothing to see, nothing to see." Well, that's kind of what this scripture in the gospel today is kind of like. Because it's grisly. I mean, it really is. If you eat my body, you eat my flesh, and you eat, drink my blood, is what Jesus is talking about. So it's kind of grisly. It's kind of, ugh. But the interesting thing is that what you really came to see, or really came to hear, or really came to understand, is under and in those words. It's just too much of a hot mess looking thing on the outside. Because the blood and all that cannibalism talk, it really is quite distracting. But at the very bottom of this, Jesus is saying, you can only find the kind of food and nourishment that your soul needs so that you might be able to live forever. That kind of powerful, transformative food or nourishment, you can't get it anyplace else. You can't get it on Amazon. You cannot get it from another person. You cannot get it by following a certain lifestyle and rules. It only comes from one place, and that is from within God, within Christ. We find ourselves nourished. Within Christ, we find ourselves transformed into the likeness of Jesus, into the likeness of God. That's what we're here for. So don't read it again. Listen to that scripture again. And see if you just don't allow yourself to get too distracted by all of the blood drinking and flesh eating. You will see that what he's really talking about is revolutionary. It means that no matter how poor you are, it means that no matter who you are, no matter what form of oppression you might find yourself under in this world, in this life. No matter, you don't have to be super wise, or you don't have to be super bright, or you don't have to have any special talents. This is available, this nourishment, this Christ within, God within, and God filling us. That's available to everybody. And that is the good news for today. Amen. And may the grace, mercy, and wisdom of God be our support, our guidance, and strength from this day forward, forevermore. Amen.